Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to Hermicraft. How's everybody doing today? You're doing good? I really hope you are. I hope that you're having a good day today. I'm doing very well myself. Thank you so much for asking. I'm having a little bit of technical issues with my computer at the moment. And it's a little bit weird. My computer keeps telling me that I have some sort of virus, and then I don't know, it just doesn't work. It keeps plinging and booping, and it's really, really annoying. But I've got it all sorted. Did a little bit of a restart. I never restart my computer, like, ever. It's always a thing that, I don't know, it's just, I keep it on. I don't know about you guys and how you work about that. But anyway, That's what's going on in my life. I'm going on a business trip again. And so I'm backlogging a little bit. This video is recorded way ahead of times, which suits me pretty well because I'm very inspired at the moment. I have a lot of things that I just want to do on the Hermicraft server. The bacon business is going pretty well. Thank you guys so much for your lovely feedback and comments and such. Can we get a lift off here on the bridge maybe? Come on now, baby. Oh, crap. Didn't do it. Oh, did we? Yeah, baby. Yeah. That's what I'm talking about. You see, we do this. Yeah, thank you all so much for hitting the like buttons on the videos and all your nice feedback. There was a comment in the video, which was it? Episode 30, saying that we should consider, it's from Ilya Novakovic, who I think he or she has been following me for quite a while. I seem to remember the name. And the question was, or the suggestion was that we should also incorporate villagers in our butchery business, which I agree. Like, there is a villager selling pork chop for emeralds, so maybe we can look at that, you know? Ooh, we got a present as well. Hello, Feather Falling. This chest has been here for ages and I haven't opened it. Soft and fluffy. Oh, that's it. That's right. Scar told me about this. He's given us Feather Falling 4. Thank you so much, Scar! You amazing person, you! I really appreciate it. I was over earlier today and looking at Scar's progression in his base, and oh my goodness! Ladies and gentlemen, I will lower for you the sound, or for me, as I do this. You have to, if you haven't, go and check his channel out and watch his stream. He is the best builder I know, probably. I've said that before, but he is extremely talented and he's building like a mine sort of thing as well, like we are doing. So, very suiting indeed, if you like that kind of build style. This pig here, I don't know. I don't think I've ever fed him. Like, he's just standing there. But we're getting quite a few pigs here, so I was thinking we should do a harvest to begin with. There was a lot of people as well saying that we should probably consider, since we're doing this into a business, the whole pig thing. We should probably make a better pig farm, like a redstone one. I've seen a lot of people saying that. I wanted to keep it simple, but I'm not completely reluctant on expanding. Let's get our baconator here. I'm not completely reluctant on expanding this. Maybe go that way for automation pig farms, or those, you know, where you have pigs in one block. Let's put this here. Oh yeah, baby, we're getting the bacon right now. The only sad thing with this 1.9 AoE update is the fact that you hit so many pigs at the same time. Xumavoy did a really good myth-busting video the other week, or the other day, on it, where he explains how looting works and what other things work with the AoE things. Because you can see here that I'm only setting one pig to fire, on fire. So the effects of the sword actually just affects one mob, is what he found out. But looting will affect all that dies from it. Doesn't really make sense here, but like for the Enderman farm, this is important. And the reason for that is obviously the same reason as any other looting, like farm, when you can throw a potion and have a looting sword in your hand, and yeah. Anyway, go check his video out. He's much better at explaining them technical things than I am. We gotta make sure we don't slay Mr. and Mrs. Pig here. But I like, you know, at one point there you get pushed around a little bit by mobs as well. And it's kind of a cool feeling to be in the middle of this. I don't know why. I don't know if I'm, I may not be sane in my head here, but it's a fun thing. And of course, cooking with Iskall. This is how we do it, Etho. Uh-huh, we just made loads of bacon. There was also some suggestions that I'd like to say, and thank you for. I bought some steak from our competitor, by the way. We got to keep him low stocked. Yeah, there was a few. Ooh, we got to store the bacon as well. There was a few suggestions on the topic of naming the bacon where people are saying that, you know, we should definitely incorporate different type of pork chops so we could have, I don't know what they're called in English, but all the English words for like pork meat, right? So we got bacon, we got pork chop, sausages maybe, we just renamed them, you know? I think that was a fantastic idea. Perfect landing. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I want to start building the butchery, steakhouse, whatever, shop today. All right, I feel very inspired at the moment. And to do this, and I saw a lot of comments was really happy about us building in our base. We may go there later and do some work there as well. We got loads of things to do, but I want to get this started today. So I got some stuff together here. Usually when I start a build, you'll know this if you watched a few videos of mine, I usually start with creating like a block chart. And I think that's a really good idea to do as general. Let me show you what I mean here. I don't have all the blocks that I want for this build yet, though. So I'm going to have to collect a few things. But we're going to use cobblestone. And the accent of cobblestone is going to be andesite. This is how I think when I build, by the way, in case you were wondering. The accent of cobblestone is going to be andesite. So we're going to use that. That's going to be our background block. As our foreground block, we're going to use bricks and all its variants. I don't have any here, but like cracked brick is going to be part of that. Not mossy, but cracked. And maybe even smooth a stone. Then I want to use pink clay, which I don't have at the moment. But I'm going to have to go and get some. I want to use that as our trim block. Accent, which is the orange, if we look at the Guardian. And then for trim, haven't really decided yet. I don't know if we need another block for trim. Maybe coal blocks. Maybe coal or maybe dark oak. Like a darker, almost blackish brick. If nether brick was black like it is in my pack, I'd use nether brick. But since we're playing on a server and nether brick is that stupid Bulgari color for everybody else, we can't really use it. That's just a little bit about the design that I want to go with for this butcher thing. There were so many good suggestions talking about steakhouses, American native shop, Naomi, I think, said. There's quite a bit of interesting stuff to read. For me, though, I wanna kind of go the steakhouse way. I think that's cool. Let's just see if we can map this out. I want to create a chimney. The first thing we create here, I should say as well, there's a reason I want to go with a stony build again. And that's because we have this guardian, which is popping a lot with the stone. And I still want to do a lot of work around it to make it fit the mesa better. I think we can do it. It's going to be hard. Hello, I. But if we get another stone building here, we're kind of connecting things together. We're bridging over to wood because that's what Scar uses over here. We're definitely going to be in the same level as the Hermit Horses because it uses cobblestone, right? So we're kind of bridging that huge gap that we have at the moment from the Guardian. So we're helping out the Guardian as well, you know what I'm saying. Anyway, I want to start by making a chimney, and I think we're going to have the entrance on this way. So let's mark that out maybe first. We say that the entrance to the building will be here, and I want a 3-wide big entrance so people can easily see what we're doing. So we'll have the entrance there about, and then I want to come into the building, and the first thing you kind of see would be this chimney. And we're not going to build a huge building like the Guardian was a massive, massive project. I want to keep this a little bit smaller. So let's see. The chimney could be there. Yeah. This is going to work out cool. Okay. So I have a plan for this chimney, which I'm really excited about. And I think you guys may think is cool. We'll see what you guys say. We'll see. It's got to be thinking. We're going to need... Did I have andesite? Yes, I do. Perfect. Okay. So if we go, yeah, let's do this. We're gonna place down glass panes right here. This is basically gonna be like a cooking oven. Let's just see, do we wanna come up with a floor or anything, or do we wanna place the floor on this level that we're at now? I think we can do this. We can do this. I'm gonna have two glass panes, like as all right? And then, kind of thinking we'll place fire. Because fire is gonna be important in this build. Because, you know, fire is just steakhousey. Listen to that sound. Just gives that warmth feel. And then I want to make sure that this... Ooh, we need cobblestone stairs as well. I want to make sure that you kind of... You feel the warmth and you get kind of invited and inspired to eat some pork chop, I suppose. Or some bacon when you come into the pork chop shop. Boop, boop, boop. Do something like that. Maybe even switch this over. And then we're going to now go with the whole block chart thing that I said. So everything that I do in cobblestone here is going to be background. And this will give us some dimensions, right? I'll talk about that glass pane in a second. So if we do this and then come over like so. Yeah, that's pretty cool. Maybe we want to go and make like a... Ooh, you know what? We can do this. Oh, baby. Hold on. No. Let's do this. This is something I do in my single player world, which, by the way, if you haven't checked out Iskall's Island, you should totally do it. It's really cool. I'm having a lot of fun there. We're building a lot of stuff. But this trick here is I use that a lot in my single player. Yeah, that's cool. That's like an oven, right? That's where we cook the pigs. Not really, but you know, that's what we want them to think. Okay, and then let's go fill this in. And I'm not texturizing this yet. And remember, the texture for... Let's take the wings off. The texture for the cobblestone is andesite. So just to give you an idea, we'll go like that. Throw in one here. Maybe one up here. We could possibly even go with gravel, but I think it's going to be enough with this. It's going to look very like rustic. All right, cool. Then I want to create a pen back here. And this is why I have the glass pane. I'm kind of thinking that this will hopefully make it look like we can have pigs in the oven and they'll never get burnt. We're gonna have to try that out though, but my plan is to fill this little thing with pigs. You know, just two or three. And I think that's gonna look really cool actually now that I see it. We may want to bring... Let's say that this is the height, right? And then we may want to bring this glass pane up a little bit. Boop, 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 boop. Like so. And... Yeah, no, I think that's good. Then I want to make this whole thing into look like a chimney, and that's gonna pop... That's going to make the building pop. And I think I'm going to make it kind of an organic chimney, but pretty tall. So maybe we'll come up like this. Ooh, I'm out of cobble. Harrow. Yeah. That gives the feeling that I want. Okay. Then foreground. Come on now. We go back to the block idea. Foreground is brick. So that would come here. Like so, and maybe we'll wrap it like this. Yep, I like that, and we'll put these here. Oh, baby, we're talking. It's very, very simple build so far, but this is looking pretty gorgeous. I may even want to bring that in, actually. Let's see what happens if we do this. Because I kind of want that cozy, you know, sparkling, almost Christmassy feel. Oh, yeah, this is better. Oh, that's much better, baby. Come on now. Come on. That's so much better. Then for the ground, we could bring the cobblestone out. Or this is where I would use the trim block, like a coal block. Right. I don't have any cobble. We have some slabs, though, that we can use. Just make it look very, like, rustic and stuff. I like it. Oh, my goodness. We are definitely onto something here, ladies and gentlemen. Come on, guys, you're going to be on display. It's a fantastic mission and things. It's really bad. Go in there, you. Go in there, pig. Oh, we got it. We got him. Come on now. And you go down. Boop. So we got some pigs installed in the furnace. Installed in the furnace. Wow. Finding new ways of expressing ourselves. working a little bit on this chimney, and I'm going around and I'm trying. I want this to be. I want like different. Ooh, dang it! I want like different heights and stuff. But I want it to be pretty tall because this building is gonna be fairly small. Is my plan. Ooh. Jeez, I'm derping like there's no tomorrow. It's gonna be fairly small, and I think a good thing to do is have like something that sticks out, right? So, coming around like so, adding slabs, trying to add slabs or stairs on all of these so that we don't get mob spawns. We may want to bring this in actually. We may want to go like this as well now that I see it. And then, ooh, this is good. Oh, baby, come on now. This is, of course, what we do. So we bring it in, we shape it. I may want to take it down a bit, a notch then again. A notch? I created Minecraft notch, but you have an English word as well in the dictionary. Go like that and that, and maybe here we can have a stair. One important thing that I was going to do up here. Did I bring... Crap. Didn't bring what I needed. Boop. Let's do that. Let's just have a look at how we're sitting right now, okay? Ooh, this completely threw it. With the pigs, by the way, I accidentally killed one, so we only have two. So I'm going to breed it up to three. I think three is a good number. I killed one because I needed to install slabs. And this guy forgot! I wanted to have slabs that they stand on, and that's for two, or for one reason. If you look at this now, they're like lifted up. I think that looks really, really cool. Like, you can clearly see them inside there. But yeah. That chimney is working for us. Okay, we're going to add a little bit of a trick here. Take the elytra off, Fiskal. Stop freaking jump boosting yourself. I'm sorry. I do apologize. Let's sleep as well. We're going to add a little bit of a trick that I think is going to be important. Smoke and particles and sound and all that kind of stuff in Minecraft, I feel is very, very fun to play around with. It's often like... missed, I suppose, in like survival Minecraft, but in creative people do it a lot, and I think it's missed in survival because it's a little bit harder. It can be a little bit trickery. Ooh, that's cool. Okay, let's do that there. Yeah, that's cool. It's a little bit more tricky to implement in places and such, but check this out. Here's my idea. We will come up here and then we'll place a fire down there. Okay, so netherrack goes on there. And I did bring the flint and steel. And that should generate enough smoke for it to look like smoke is actually coming out of the chimney from all the way down there. From all the way down here. Yeah, we may want to take down that block there. It's a little bit off. But there's definitely smoke coming out. It's a little bit weird how little smoke is coming out, though. I'll work on it a little bit, you know. I'll go back and forth. We still need to implement some andesite. Another thing that we are going to do with the texture here is we're going to come and we're going to do staircases and make it look bulky. I did it a little bit here. Or look chipped, I mean. All right, ladies and gentlemen, I've done some work. I've been playing now for about an hour, testing different things. You can see it over there. You can see what I'm talking about. We're playing with fire. We're playing with fire. We did the fire in the oven and we did the smokestack on the chimney, which still looks very rough. We need to make that taller still. But I've been doing some more things. And I've caught a butcher villager. And I think it's a butcher anyway. We call him Sir Butcher. I call him Sir Butcher and I put him in here. Unfortunately, he's carrying that block there, and he doesn't want to pick up. I gave him bacon, but he didn't like it. Didn't appreciate it. Oh, this thing is still here. Fantastic. Okay. So I've been playing a little bit with fire. I got this vision in my head that I wanted it to look a little bit like Hell's Kitchen. You know Gordon Ramsay's show? Crazy guy? Right? There are like cutscenes. I tried to find this on Google, but I've seen cutscenes when I've been watching that Hell's Kitchen show, where they're opening the restaurant and it cuts into like the front of Hell's Kitchen, and I try to make this feel the same way. So you got some stuff here, but more importantly, switched out the pink for fire here, and I think that's doing it for us. I think it's gorgeous. Need to punch you away and put that there. Okay, very cool. Get rid of you. Boom. Still need to work a little bit on the entrance part. But I think we're sitting pretty good. Then, as I was doing this, I remember seeing a B00 video the other day where he built something in his new Swamp Kingdom that looks like a ruin. But it's interesting because he's playing with smoke. And what he did, let me show you here. He basically started using fires underneath half shrabs. And I gotta say, it looks absolutely amazing. So I wanted to implement that here as well and see if we could build on it. I tried it here. This is basically a cauldron with fire underneath it. And since this is not a full block, the smokestacks comes through it as well. And even some flames at times, which I think is pretty cool. Now, I want to take this to the next level. I kind of want to implement it in the floor here. The only problem with fire is, of course, that we're going to lose out on wood. I don't know if the chest burns down, but there'd be the pigs in there. I don't know if the chest burns down, but I think we can play around a little bit here. I wanted to do... Yeah, let's try this. So we come down three blocks, and then we do netherrack. Put that on fire. Or is that one too low down? No. That's good. Then if we use a staircase instead here, a cobblestone stair, I guarantee you... Shouldn't say too much, Iskal, but I'm pretty sure that that will come through as well. Let's try that, okay? So we come over here and we do boom. Ooh, fire spread over there, okay. Yeah, look at that. The smokestacks are coming through. It gives a really cool feeling to this whole building. I kind of want it everywhere. Ooh, we got water underneath here. That's right. Iskal did a poor job at covering up the lake that was here. But we do that and get rid of you and down here. Why do I have a massive issue in Minecraft, and that is that I place all the blocks on number four. Like I press number four on my keyboard, and yeah, it's really bad. I need to stop that. But we can do that, and this even works if we have a slab here, I think. Oh no, it doesn't. Okay. Never mind. But maybe here we do a cauldron. I don't know if that makes sense, but it kind of, you know, it looks a little bit cool. What if we take a carpet? And I'm going to go and borrow one from Scar, because I didn't bring any. I'm sorry. He's kind of doing the same thing there with torches, but the smoke is a little bit less big. Oh, yeah. I don't know if the carpet will catch on fire, though. It's, I don't know if they burn. But we get a little bit of it here. You know, there are tons of things that we can do. Oh, that fire is spreading. Okay, so that will not work then, I guess. I think that's what happened there. Or do I have an air block? No, I don't. Ooh, ghost block. Okay, well, there are tons of things that we can play around with. Now, for the roof of this bad boy, I'm kind of a little bit inspired, because we can't really use wood too much since we're playing with fire. But I'm a little bit inspired by Exumavoid's roof that he's doing on his base. If you haven't seen it, you probably have. But if you haven't, go check it out. He's done some absolutely amazing roofs that are just very inspiring. And he's using this here, the gray stained clay. And I think that's going to be suiting here as well. Now, I have no idea how he did the roofs. And I'm really bad at building roofs. So this is a humming and umming situation for Iskal where I have to go back and forth. But we got a few different options. I think that color is perfect. I brought brown because I want to see what that looks like. But I think, you know, it's not too bad. But the gray is definitely better. What about black? People call it the extra brown one. But I kind of like black clay. Did I bring? Oh, yes, I did. Okay, let's try this then. Boop, boop, boop. And yeah, let's just make a stack. Will this work as well, or is this better, worse? Definitely works. It's not a roof creator, but it's all right. You know, we're sitting pretty good with this roof. I like the color, and it's a very simplistic roof. I did these corners in the back here as well, and some people may think this is bad because it's not. Not completely like symmetrical with this, but you know, I kind of think that it works. I kind of feel the vibe. Maybe we can go like this though. Yeah. This is how the chimney looks from the behind as well. And I made it a little bit taller. The idea, let's just do this as well. Boop, 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 boop. The idea with that chimney is, of course, that as we look at this building, the chimney pops, right? And it really does. I like that. Now, it's a little bit scarcely on the front here. So I'm thinking, I got a plan. Boop, boop, boop. Take them 3 blocks away. And then... We could totally have a pig up there. I don't know if that's going to make sense. We could have a pig up here. Or, ooh, you know what I just realized. You know it. Iskall, stop using the elytra wings on camera. Sorry. Do apologize. Let's put some fire up there. Maybe that's better. I was thinking first, let's have a pig that runs around. But this may actually look much better. Actually, would we... Jeez! I'm bad at this game called Minecraft. Hi. Okay. Yeah, we won't be able to see it from below. And I think that may do the trick. Maybe we close this up. 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 Maybe we close this up. Hi. English. You know, it's weird for me. Some of the days, my English just does not work at all. It's like completely malfunctioning. And I use it a lot. I speak so much English in the YouTube videos, in my work. It's just crazy. Okay, for now. I'll go up and texturize that a little bit better. Yeah, that's pretty bad. But that's looking pretty cool. Okay, didn't like insta love that though. Let's try something here. It's a little bit too squarey. Grab you and grab you. What happens if we do this? And this would be kind of like the logo of the shop. Oh, baby. Come on now. Hell's Kitchen. Here we go. It's burning everywhere right now in your face. But I like that. I think that's very good. Wow. There's some massive construction work going on outside my window. Okay. One other thing that I wanted to do, like the symbol for this shop. It obviously has to do with fire and food. But I kind of want to create like a fork mini statue. Maybe just on the side, like not symmetrical with the other things. And I'm thinking something very simple. You know how people do tridents? That's what I'm thinking here. So we'll do boop, boop. We're using dark oak here as well. Maybe something like that. Or is that too like looking like a cacti or a guy? I don't know. Woo-hoo-hoo! All right, creeper. Stupid idiot. I've had 3 creeper explosions today. Yeah, two of them has blown up that chest. I really don't like creepers. That's okay, though, we can fix. I don't know, it's kind of interesting. Like, it's not necessarily saying what it is. We could possibly make something here. Looks a little bit like a cacti even, like a stone cacti. But it's interesting, I quite like it. Like a logo. When I did it, it was a fork, but we'll see what other people anticipated as. I'm adding some finishing touches to this. Maybe we can try and make like a little thing there. I don't know what it is. I know people are going to say, please have some blood. And I like that idea. Where the butcher is, so a little bit of redstone dotted like that. Maybe not there. I can dig. I'm so terrible at the whole, like, interior, you know, using Minecraft blocks to make them look like something else type of thing. But I do my best. I think we need an anvil as well. I don't know why, but it just gives it that feeling. Maybe I'll remove the hopper, actually. I didn't like that. I got an idea as I was laying down the last bits and pieces outside. I'll show you what I did. But I got an idea that... I should have implemented or should have thought about, and it's still not too late because it's Minecraft, but I'll have to think about that a little bit more. Maybe we can implement like a fire icon, like using the new glass panes, right? Try and stick with me here. We could use orange, yellow, and red. Try and make a cool flame thing coming out. I don't know if that's too modern though, because we can't go on with that medieval thing. But anyway, there we have it, ladies and gentlemen. You can see on the outside here, I did the floor different. And I gotta say, that really, 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 for me, lifts this whole building. we're going to come and we're going to try and, you know, make sure that the landscaping and all that makes sense afterwards. But since Iskall is going on business trip in, and I'm going to be gone for 5 days. So when you see this, it's been a few days since I built it. I don't want this spoiled. Okay. I think this is a good marketing thing as well. We're going to build like a cube around this. Okay. And maybe just go like that. A cube of clay. And this is good marketing wise as well, because it kind of adds a little bit. We leave some of the things outside, right? Ooh. Could do that. Yeah. It kind of gives the hermits a like what's going on? What's inside there? We can't wait to see it feeling. And then on the grand opening day, which is going to be when I come back, I've hopefully used my work laptop to stock up on pigs and such. And I'll just place down some torches here, I guess. I'll hopefully use that to stock up on pork and bacon and all that kind of stuff. So we can come back and we can have like a grand opening ceremony, and they will have seen a clay box here up until now. I think though, I kind of want to have the roof open because I want the... Ooh, that's the wrong one. I want the chimney to kind of shine through. But the problem with that is elytras, man. They'd be flying. I think I'm going to leave like small little gaps of windows and stuff hanging out. I'm not sure. Yeah, that could look pretty cool. Life's like a box of chocolate. Chocolate? Oh, I can't spell that. You never know what you're going to get. Escalade 85. Okay, so I got the spoiler box up and I kind of left some hints and stuff. We left this thing outside and the chimney is there, but the roof is covering up everything. So even if you fly over this, you can see the chimney, which, you know, is kind of cool. You may have at this stage then seen this and wondered what it is. But that's the kind of hype feeling that I want to create for the other hermits here. We played with fire today, and I'm happy how this building turned out. It's gonna be a good business. It's our dentist. It's what's gonna pull people over to this area of town, make them buy some from the Guardian shop and stuff. A lot of people have been complaining about it being too dark in here, and I see what happened now. I see people have put down torches. There's the pig that I lost. Okay. People have been putting down torches. We gotta figure that out someday as well. Make sure that it's not dark enough for creepers and stuff to spawn inside. I don't like it too light though. I think it's a little bit of a challenge when there be dangers around corners. Anyway, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. I hope that you have enjoyed the episode. Thank you for being positive and happy and amazing to me. Leave some nice words down below. Hit the like button if you enjoyed it. And I'll see you in the next episode.